CEO Ronnie from Creative Difference. I've got two different TruCut sanding pads here. We've got a 5-inch pad and we have a 6-inch pad, and they're both 2000 grit. What we're going to do is we're going to do just a little test, just kind of see if the size matters when sanding a bowling ball. We got a bowling ball here. We're going to sand half of the bowling ball with one side, half the other bowling ball with the other side, and then we're going to evaluate the pads. Both pads are brand new. So we're going to have Dustin go ahead and grab the 5-inch pad first. He's got normal size hands, nothing crazy. And we're going to have him go through a certain amount of sanding times. He's going to actually count. He's counting in his head so he knows what the amount of sanding times he is going over the ball. And we're going to do this just so we can get a real good feel for, you know, how much difference does it make if you use a 5-inch sanding pad or a 6-inch. Obviously, if you were sanding the ball, you would sand the entire ball. For this test, we are actually just showing, let me spin the ball around. Yep. For this test, we're just showing what you would do if, well, we're only staying in one particular section of the bowling ball so that it's kind of equitable. But obviously, if you're doing this, you're going to want to sand the entire surface of the ball. And you have to sand the entire surface of the ball to keep the ball legal according to USBC regulations. So he's counting and getting us a good consistent cut with both the 5-inch and the 6-inch. And now we can look at both of the pads just to kind of get a feel for what actually is happening. There you can kind of see a couple things, right? So with the 5-inch pad, there actually appears to be more usage, more contact. And that's really because his hand is going to be more apt. Matter of fact, put your hand like this, Dustin, on the table right there, on the table. So his hand with the 5-inch pad, right, is going to be able to get more coverage because the bulk of the pressure is coming from this part of the hand, not the fingertips. Obviously, with the 6-inch pad, you have more on the fingertips and less in the center, so he couldn't even get enough pressure here, which is where you actually have the most force with your hand. And obviously here, we're missing as well. So by looking at the two pads, you can see, obviously, there we go. That's about the same right there. There is some difference. You're actually being able to get a little bit better cut, a little more consistent cut, I would tell you, with the 5-inch pad over the 6-inch pad. And you're going to be able to get, because of that, you're going to be able to get a little more even surface on the bowling ball. Now, obviously, go ahead and wipe both sides of the bowling ball off. Because at the end of the day, it's all about making sure you're as consistent as possible by using sanding pads, especially the TruCut sanding pads. They are made for bowling balls. They're going to cut to the number that's written on the pad. And obviously, you can kind of see here, we're getting a much more detailed usage of the cut with the 5-inch over the 6-inch pad. So we'll just take a look at the bowling ball real quickly here. Just take a look at both sides of the bowling ball. So there was the, you know what side that was?
5-inch.
That's the 5-inch side, and this is the 6-inch side. You really can't tell a lot of difference there, obviously. But the important part to note is that TruCut does come in two sizes, 5-inch or 6-inch, and depending on your use case, maybe you've got big hands, maybe you want the 6-inch pad. If you got a normal hand, 5-inch is the way to go. If you have more questions or need more information, make sure you check us out at ctdbowling.com. Ronald Hicklin, CEO from Create the Difference. Have a great day.